Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at installing third-party keyboards in iOS 8. So the way you get third-party keyboards is you install them in the App Store, just like you would any app. And there's a special section right now for iOS 8 apps. And if you go into there, you'll see Add New Keyboards. I'll click on the See All and I can get to a quick list of some apps with third-party keyboards. Now in the future you may need to search for keyboards, or Apple may add an extra section for this. We'll have to see. Right now here are some of the first apps to offer third-party keyboards. And you install them just like you would any other app, and they'll actually appear on your home screen just like a regular app. So I stuck some of these apps into a folder so they'd be out of the way. The apps themselves aren't usually that useful, although some of them contain tutorials on how to use the specific keyboard. Now just having the apps on your iOS device isn't enough for them to show up. You actually have to activate them. So go into your Settings app under General, Keyboard, and tap Keyboards again, and you can see a list of all the keyboards you're currently using. You can add a new keyboard and then you'll see more third-party keyboards that you haven't yet activated. You can select one and it will then appear there. Now that's usually not enough. You have to also select it and then select Allow Full Access. Sometimes keyboards access the internet for more content, or will do things like perhaps get names out of your contacts to make it easier to type those names, things like that. So depending on the keyboard, you may or may not need that, or you may need it for advanced functionality. So once you have all these in here, you're ready to use them. So you can use these apps anywhere you would normally use a regular keyboard. So here I am in Pages, but you could be in Mail, you could be in Notes, you could be in Messages. And to get to another keyboard, you'll notice the little globe-like button at the bottom left. Now you can tap that and it will take you to the next keyboard. On the Apple keyboard, the standard one that I'm looking at, you can actually tap and hold and you'll get a pop-up with all the keyboards that you've got. I've got the Emoji keyboard, which is also built into iOS, and we had that in iOS 7 as well. But you can select another keyboard, like say, let's select Swiftkey. And then you can see it's brought up this other keyboard here. So Swiftkey has been around for a while on Android, and its big feature is predictive text. So you can see words appearing at the top there. And I can actually even stop in the middle of typing a word here, hit the space bar, and it will complete it. And it's got a little bit better of a predictive engine at this point, maybe than iOS 8 has by itself. So you may want to give it a try if you really like predictive text. Now on the iPhone you can use Swiftkey to actually swipe between letters to type words. You can't do that on the iPad for some reason, but you can do it using TouchPal, another keyboard here. So for instance, I can just sort of tap where the letter T is and then drag my finger around to type the rest of the word. So you can see how you can do less finger movement really with this, or at least less taps, so it might be interesting as another way to type. And you can see there's still predictive text there at the top. So the MyScript keyboard actually allows you to draw letters instead of actually typing them on keys. And when it makes a mistake, you can backspace by just doing a backwards dash there, and space forward by forwards dash. So it's kind of an interesting concept, and you also get the predictive text at the top. There's a lot you can do, and some people may really like this. Now Text Expander is an app that's been around forever on the Mac. It allows you to have text shortcuts to do various things. And here's what the keyboard looks like when you're typing text, but the real key to using it is to using the app first to set things up. So let's look at the Text Expander app here, and basically you can create these groups of snippets, and I've created one here which basically just uses TMS as a abbreviation for this is a test period. You can do much longer ones. Some of these are pretty long, things like that you can have short abbreviations for. You can even use some extra special characters, like for instance substituting dates and things like that in there. But let's take a look at just using the one I created there. So when I type TMESS with the Text Expander keyboard, I should get that sentence there. So we'll switch over to Pages. And there you go. I didn't even have to do anything afterwards to activate it. It automatically recognizes it as an abbreviation. And I can make this a really short thing, like a signature at the end of an email, have a series of them, or make it something very long that can be inserted, like say a form letter that I respond to people via email with. So with these first third-party keyboards, you can really see the potential here. I'm sure soon we'll get lots of different innovation, lots of competition between the different keyboards and improvements. So keep watching the App Store and seeing what comes up and trying out a few things. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost.com.